What have you got yourself into today here at CSC? You're not sure?
Nope.
You got a harness on?
Nope.
I think you might be skydiving.
I think that's what I'm doing.
Oh my goodness. Want to say anything to anybody out there before you jump out of a perfectly good airplane?
See you when I get home, boo.
Yeah, all right.
Life was normal. Life was energetic. Life was nonstop. With her, I guess life is a little unnormal with the skydiving. She's a real go-getter. Niki, she was healthy. We just went to sleep. And to wake up at 3:30 in the morning to this, knowing in a conscious mind that she's dying, because that's what was going on. I'm sitting there watching my wife die.
I woke up. I don't even think I still fully comprehended what was happening at that time. I knew I was in a hospital, didn't know why, but there were people surrounding my bed, but it was my mom and my family, my friends.
She went to sleep Monday and I woke up Friday, laying in a hospital bed with all types of tubes in her, so.
The doctor came out afterwards. He was standing against the wall, and what he then said to us was, "One in a million make this. I don't understand what's going on. I cannot believe what just happened."
You know, not having any pre-existing conditions, there was no reason why it just happened. They told me if they had looked at my heart 30 seconds before, they still wouldn't have known what was about to happen or what was about to take place.
You kind of see these things on TV, but you don't see it until, like, firsthand. It's a different perspective from that. And so I can say, yeah, it was kind of shocking as the process went on.
I had pretty much freaked my kids out. We like to watch Tom and Jerry. There's an episode of Tom and Jerry where he's trying to get to heaven, and God keeps sending him back down because he has to get this signature from Jerry. So I was like, okay, so you know how Jerry was going up to the escalator? Okay, mommy kept going up there, but he kept sending me back, telling me it wasn't my time yet. So that's kind of how I explained it to him at that time.
We still don't have answers why it even happened. So coming home was basically, for me, walking on the eggshells.
It was August. It's the kids' first day of school, and that night before, I could not sleep really good. It was really hard to sleep. Got back to the house and could not walk up the stairs. I had literally no energy to do any of that.
Transplant was a very big word. It felt like the whole bottom of life had just fell out. And it was up to Niki. And I said, whatever you decide, I'm here.
When they made the decision she was going to stay in the hospital to wait for the heart, even though they told us an estimated amount of time, we really moved in.
Instead of just sitting there watching the second hand tick, 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 we decided that we had to make it normal.
I'm a busybody at all times. I always have something to do. So sitting still probably would have drove me insane. I had the pictures up of the family so I can see them on a daily basis. For the holidays, I decorated. So we got a Christmas tree, and birthdays we did. So I would decorate the room and we do birthday parties.
We had to spend my 16th birthday in the hospital. We spent Christmas in the hospital. First day of school was in the hospital.
Thanksgiving dinner at the hospital. New Year's Eve at the hospital. We had no other choice.
And I think she wanted her children to still feel like, I'm still here, so let's keep doing these things because it's not over yet. So we don't give up on anything.
You gotta try to stay as positive as possible because it's easy to slip into that gray area. And it doesn't mean that I didn't have those days. I did have them.
She said the heart that was out there for her was being used. And when it was done being used, then it was her turn to use it.
We all die at some point. if that's the case and this person has to go and that's their time anyway, then I'm just picking up where they left off.
The day the heart came, it was the best day of my life, I think.
I had been in the hospital 172 days, so I was in August 24th of 2014. They offered the heart to me January 31st, 2015.
When the time actually came and she called me, I had to make her repeat it like 6 times.
She goes in this very solemn voice, "Mom, it's time."
Once I heard the tone in her voice, then I knew, and I got all excited. Knocked my lunch over in my work truck, so I ruined my lunch. Everything, I'm going crazy.
Then I screamed to the top of my lungs, and it was just more one of those, like, I can't believe it.
All right, so it might take us a couple times to place it right, but we're gonna place it.
Okay.
Hopefully, right where we need it.
Did you hear anything?
Yes.
Yeah, it's still going in there.
It's still going? Okay.
Cool.
January 26th, 2016. Dear donor family, thank you. These 2 words seem inadequate for the gift of life you have given me. The one thing I know about my donor is that they had a very strong heart. Although not knowing anything about them personally, they must have been kind, caring, compassionate, and generous, something they would have learned from you and their family. Your family has given me a chance not only to live, but to continue to be a loving mother, a loving wife, daughter, grandmother, sister, and friend.
Hi. Thanks for letting me invade your space.
Sure.
So I wanted to bring you this.
I'll give you a hug. I'm a hugger. I could do that.
Sorry.
So much, Niki.
No problem.
You are a true inspiration.
Good luck. See on the other side.
Yes.
You received a gift. You don't deserve it. It's not something you can bargain for or even pay for that matter. But now that you have it, what are the next steps?
You don't know what the reasons were that you were saved. Why was she spared? She doesn't know yet, so she just decided, I'll give back.
I feel like that's part of the reason why I'm still here, to help those that are going through something that I've also experienced and to help them get through it in the best way.
Once she got in touch with the American Heart Association, she just wanted to do whatever you guys had going on, whatever she found. I want to be a part of it.
American Heart Association, everybody hears about. But until it touches you personally, you don't know what they really do. So since heart disease, it doesn't know race or color, it doesn't know age or size or shape, it affects everybody. So I want to be a part of something that's going to help bring awareness to that, to help those that can save them prior to things happening. There is so much to be thankful for, and I could go on and on. Because of your generosity, I can only hope that I am able to justify this wonderful gift. I want you to know that my family and I love you more than you can even imagine. My plan is to take care of this heart just like the precious gift it is. Thank you from the bottom of my heart, and I hope to hear from you soon. Your recipient.